Hi, Bonai. My name is Alia. My question is, where does all moons come from, and why does gas giants not have gas moons?
Wow, that is a great question, Aria. Wow. First of all, I was alive when people figured out or satisfied themselves as where our moon came from. And it's generally agreed that our moon was created when the Earth was hit with another pretty big thing, another asteroid. And the impact was very hard, and the energy of the smashing was converted to heat. And both the Earth and the moon were hot and molten, and they both cooled off. And here we are with this other separate thing in orbit around us. Now, why do gas giants not have gas moons is a great question, and the answer is almost certainly because of gravity. So when you have these little things that spun off of, let's say, Jupiter or Saturn, they were too small to sustain themselves as just balls of gas. The gas shrunk down, gravity pulled it down and formed a solid thing. Whereas on Jupiter and Saturn, there's so much spin, so much heat created that they're held in a gaseous state, or what we would call gaseous state, by the energy that's coming out of them. Whereas the smaller ones cooled off so much that they turned solid. It is just a fantastic question, Arya. And astrophysicists or planetary scientists speculate about this all the time. But what a fantastic thing that you made this observation. The moons of Jupiter, the big ones, Io, Callisto, Europa, and Ganymede, those big moons are cooled off. They're not gaseous like Jupiter, that whom they or what they orbit. That's fantastic. Wow. And maybe more will be learned about this. And I got to tell you, Aria, it's very reasonable that in your lifetime, we will send the right spacecraft to Europa and the moon of Saturn, Enceladus, and Titan, and look for signs of life. Instead of being a gas giant, in this one example, Europa is a moon of Jupiter that has twice as much seawater as the Earth, and that water is under a layer of ice. And I mention it because it's evidence of how things cool off when they're in space and they're small, or relatively small. The ice forms because of the heat of creation, the things smashed together, that heat is radiated into space. So there's a crust of ice, but the water underneath is kept liquid by the gravitational exercising of its orbit around Jupiter. It's amazing. What an observation, Aria. You're making my day. I hope you will be involved in missions to Europa and you will look for signs of life below the ice. I mean, who knows? If you have an ocean for 4.5 billion years, things are going to happen. Could be living things there. Could be Europanians out there, fish people that you'll interact with. Keep us posted. Thank you.